You're still watching Waze now. The aim of Aspergillosis. Aspergillosis days. Yes. We are learning every day. Is to raise awareness of the fungal infection that, like several other fungal infections worldwide, is often underdiagnosed. Now, diagnosis of Aspergillosis.
G.
Gilliosis, yes. It's difficult and requires specialist expertise, like the UK National Centre and the Europe Confederation of Medical Mycology Centre of Excellence. But it also frequently occurs alongside much more common illnesses such as asthma, tuberculosis, COPD, fungal nodules, occasionally gets mistaken for also lung tumour. I mean, I don't know, I've never heard it before. So I thought it was important to talk about it. And I mean, it's a World Aspergillosis Day. Perfect. So we learn every day. All right. So thank you for anyone that did not know that there was a word like that, like me.
It actually brought to mind there are two types of, special needs. Mm. We have Asperger's and we have, we also have the non-verbal. Asperger's are the verbal autistic children, and the non-verbal is just non-verbal basically. So when we have things like that, what I saw that word, what actually came to my mind was Asperger's, but in other words, I think it has to do with lungs, tumors.
This is actually,
so we need to take care of our lungs.
I don't know what it is. The doctor, Shah, I just decided to say, because it's medical, so let's
stick to
let me pretend like I know what it is. But I read about it though. It's commonly mistaken for lung tumor. Right? It's a kind of fungal infection, and it's not easily diagnosed. So there are just very few special centers. You know,
that
so that's why this day they use it to raise awareness about the disease.
Yeah. I think it should be brought to the awareness of the fore more often than
absolutely.
What we have.
So that's
today.
Why we talked about it today. So absolutely. Thank you again. In case you didn't, if you don't want to thank me, I'll thank myself. All right. So who is starting first? Let me come to Jennifer. What did you find for us in the news today?
I'm sure everybody said we're waiting for news. COVID-19, Presidency defends Buhari's removal of mask in public. Buhari was addressing the public in Katsina State and he wasn't wearing his mask. So people have been coming for him or dragging him on social media, and also PDP has been doing the same. His assistant came out to say that he only removed the mask when he was close to the microphone and he was addressing everyone, when he actually wanted to speak. That aside that time, he had his mask on throughout, and then he called it the childish antics of the PDP. So apparently the PDP are just coming for the president. They just wanted to drag him for dragging sick.
Let me step in here. I'm just going to say a very short sentence. Let me be a bit hilarious or humoristic here. We have Joe Biden. Joe Biden always stays in front of his camera microphone when he's speaking, and he has his face mask on. Why can't we have a leader that can have his face mask on after saying or giving us the order to wear our face masks, and also observe the precautionary measures for COVID. So he is not leading by example.
Okay, leave it there.
And if you look at the picture, you can see that the microphone is
the way down.
Around, all the way down. It's not close to his mouth. So that's an easy spread for the guy close to him.
Even the guy close to him.
Even the guy, he's not safe because he's very, very close. He's too close. It's too close.
They don't have COVID now.
2 meters away.
He needs to go and do tests.
Let's move on. But I keep saying that, you see, leadership is very easy. That's why they say lead. Lead is that you're in front.
Lead by examples. The generals, when they go to war, they are in front. So we have the news. What caught my attention was corruption, again, by our president. Presidency blames Nigerians for transparency's poor ranking. Now, look, we all know that currently we have been rated the 26th in the country, or the world, as being the most corrupt country in the world. So we have a problem currently going on in Nigeria, which Uncle Garba Shehu has said that we, the Nigerians, are the ones to be indicted and not the administration of the president. Mm. I totally disagree with him. I think we have played, it's a symbiotic relationship. You can't keep pointing fingers when the government has not stepped up. They brought up the COVID, the registration of NIN during the period of COVID. And at the same time, they haven't done things right. They have allowed the officials to catch COVID at the same time, and they've also allowed them to extort the populace.
Yeah.
So in every ramification, this is just a simple example. Transparency is not our forte in Nigeria. When they bring up something, we always try to make it as first it might seem easy. I was listening to the news recently and I heard somebody talk about CAC being very seamless. But after some time, it became a tug of war because the lady who was actually doing it wasn't able to get the certificate out already. It's not even up to 2 weeks. They're already having challenges with the new update in the website. So everything that has to do with the government, we lack transparency, we lack accountability. I've said this time and time and time again. We lack poor infrastructure has also led to what? Corruption in Nigeria. When the people do not have what they want, at the end of the day, what will they do? They'll seek means to make it happen for them. There is so much. Education is a talk for another day.
Okay, this way.
Talking about transparency, I really don't know why Garba is bringing it to the citizens. I think it was this month when we talked about, or where I think I was one who found it in the news, about the 2021 budget. Mm-hmm. Now, there was no transparency at all. Most of the things they budgeted for, they could not account for it. And they were asked, but then there was nothing was accountable. When they just brought up figures.
When they're now told to come in and account for it, that's when they now start feigning and fainting skills.
I'm joking.
Okay, can you let me take my own story now? Because you see, I don't have energy for this conversation.
It is upset.
No, you can't keep blaming the people when you've not done your part.
Okay, well, the gentleman, the Yoruba activist, Sunday Adeyemo, popularly known as Sunday Igbodo, on Monday stormed some part of Ogun State and vowed to flush out killer herdsmen in troubled areas in the state. So Igbodo, who stopped briefly in Abeokuta around 4 p.m., had a brief interaction with his supporters, later proceeded to Ketu land, where some soldiers allegedly connived with herdsmen to flog some farmers for not allowing them graze their cattle on their farm in Yewa North local government. So he is saying that any Fulani herdsman who engages in kidnapping would be flushed out. That's his vowing. And they asked him, will he limit himself to his hometown? That's the Gongo or something. That's the hometown. He said, no, everywhere in Yoruba land must bring peace. And he also lauded the state governor, that's Dapo Abiodun, for allowing him into the state. So he's moved from Oyo State now. He's gone to Ogun State. That's Abeokuta, you know. Mm-hmm. So he's trying to be bold about this because a lot of things have happened. His house has been burned, blah blah blah.
When you know,
we're hoping that you know, truly, because I saw a video Alibaba posted on social media yesterday. Kwam Won.
Okay.
Yeah, he was feeding his cattle. You know, he has
a mini ranch here and all that.
So Alibaba, the tag he wrote there is that, come, has this man asked government for money or anything? Is this not how it's supposed to be done?
Yeah.
I mean, this is a private business. Cattle ranch rearing is a private business. So would government come and fund me for my own business that I'm doing? No. Mm-hmm. So why would you say that, you know, people should? So I think it is a heated conversation. I wish Marianne was here to come and help us explain what's happening. But we'll leave it there.
I think he's stepping into the forefront of this. When you there's a saying, when you have lost something and there is nothing else to lose, you go head on and you pursue whatever.
Well, I just hope. So, you know, people will always come and attack and say it's for personal reasons, for fame and all of that. Whatever it is, the truth is,
getting the job done.
There has to be a structure when it comes to cattle grazing, because we are farmers. I would hate for my farmland to be destroyed because some cattle have come in to want to graze.
Yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. All right, so we'll take a break. When we return, we'll be discussing the healthcare structure in Nigeria. Stay with us. We'll be right back.